Hey, I've got another fun technique to share this time around. I call this one the garbage disposal, just because the way it sort of like spins up and slows down and makes these goopy, garbagey, thick textures. For the input, I'm going to be using a square wave. I think the original pitch was about here. 66 hertz. I just generated that in Sound Miner and then bounced it and looped it and stretched it out a little bit so it's down here. Like 36 hertz. You can use anything as your input, and as always, I would encourage you to try out different things if you're going to give this technique a shot. But the core idea here revolves around using the tape stop snap-in. I'm using it in SnapHeap, but I'm not really using like any of the real functionality. I'm just using the modulator here. I'm not doing any parallel processing or whatever. And on its own, tape stop does this. Where it like speeds up and slows down the recording every time you hit the button. But I think it's pretty cool if we don't hit the button, but we get SnapHeap to hit the button on its own. So if you put a modulator to control that, and then just like increase the start and stop time with like a slow LFO, it sounds like this. Which is pretty cool. It like gets nice and chunky when it slows down and gets to like the bottom of the playback speed. It's almost like a Doppler, but also not quite. I like just increasing these controls to their maximum and then like having a really slow LFO. So we get more time, more of that like in between time where it's really chunky like this. Because the interesting part is where it's spinning up and spinning down, right? So that is it in essence. That's the trick. What I'll usually do from there is I'll build on that idea. Like here, I've got three of those running on multiple bands in multipass with separate LFOs on each one. Let me make this a little bit bigger for you. And each LFO is running at a slightly different rate, and they're also slightly out of phase. So basically, you can imagine each of those tape stops is like chopping up the frequency spectrum and like, I'll stop talking, just let you hear it. They're like all out of sync and spinning up and spinning down at different times, and it's pretty fantastic. So what I did for this little processing chain here is I just like added an OTT before it, which sounds like this. And that just like brings out this horrible screeching resonance around like 9900 hertz. Which I didn't really like, so I like attenuated that. And then I put dispersers on each band at slightly different frequencies. Which is giving it that dispersery sci-fi sound. Put a chorus after it. For some more stereo width, and then just like a couple of notch filters and a limiter at the very end. And this is just to do that neuro thing. We get like moving, sweeping notch filters, and it sounds sick. And then I also just assigned a couple of random modulators, both to get the dispersers, as you can see here, all the dispersers jiggling, moving, and also the notch filters wiggling around. This one especially, wow, 20 hertz. Let's hear it. Wet, goopy, and gross. Love it. I had Gullfoss on here. I think this is just to sort of like tame up some of the low frequencies and balance it a little bit more. Yeah, not too different. You get the idea. That's it. I'm going to run through this other variation on it too that I have here, which is not using multiband, but I was using a whole bunch of other plugins. But I'm not going to talk through it. I'm just going to let that play you out. But yeah, besides that, feel free to give it a try on whatever source material you can think of and let me know how it goes. Enjoy.